also methods to ensure cross pollination. As we have seen, there are some adaptations in flowers that encourages self-pollination, but there are some adaptations that are present in flowers that ensures cross-pollination. So we first see what is dictogamy. In dictogamy, the maturation season for anthers and for stamens and carpels, they are different. That means the anthers and stigmas, they mature at different types in bisexual flower, so that prevents self-pollination. Now it is divided into two types, proandry and protogamy. In proandry, the anthers matures earlier than the stigma of the same flower, so their pollen grains are available to the stigmas, but the stigma is not it is not ready to receive these pollen grains. Now we see protogamy. Protogamy means the stigmas mature earlier so that they are pollinated before the anthers of the same flower develop pollen cells. That means the stigma, they are developed or they are ready, but the pollen grains, they are not developed. The anthers, they are not developed. So here you see the protogamy. In protogamy, the anther, if you see the anther, it has got matured, it has got developed. It breaks open and releases the pollen grains outside. But stigmas are not receptive. And if you see the protogamy, here the anthers are in closed state. They are not broken open. There is no dehiscence of anther, and the stigmas, they are receptive. So the first one is protoandry, and the second first is proandry, and the second is protogamy. I will see hypogamy. In these hypogamy, there's a physical barrier between the anthers and the stigma. If you see in the first case, there's the flower is having long style, but they have short stamens or filament. So during this, when the visitors, the pollinators, they come to visit, they first visit, because of the long style, they first visit stigma, okay, before visiting this stamens. So what happens is, the pollinators, they dust their pollen grains on stigma first, in the first flower, okay. In the second, if you see, they have a long stamen filaments, but there's a very short style. So the visitors, they first visit this stigma, and then they visit the anthers or pollen grains, and then they visit short style. So what happens is, because of it is having short stem, long stamen, the visitors first gathers all the pollen grains, and whenever they are going to the next plant, they will dust this pollen grains to the plant, and this is called as hypogamy. In self-sterility, that is called as self-incompatibility. The pollen grains of the flower do not germinate on the stigma of the same flower due to presence of same self-sterile gene. That means S1, S3 in the pistil, and S1 or S3 in the pollen grain. So if you see, there's a style. You see the female genophyte, it has S1 and S2 genes, but there's a pollen grains that have S1 S2, so they will not this pollen grains are not going to germinate on the stigma. In the second case, these are S1 and S2, the pollen grains are S1 and S3. S3 will germinate, and the third example, S1 and S2, S1, S3 and S4 are going to germinate. So this is called as self-sterility or incompatibility. Now we'll see the next, that is heterostyly. Heterostyly, there's stamens and there's styles. They're arranged at different heights, so there's no chances of self-pollination. A flower, the first example, a flower with long style, medium and short stamens, so there is no chances of pollination. Second, flower with medium style and long and short stamens. And the third, flower with short style and medium and long stamens. Okay, now the next, apart from this dictogamy, then hercogamy, then self-styled, then heterostyly, the one more example is unisexuality. Whenever the flower is unisexual, that means if it contains only one gametophyte, that is, if it contains angiosperm or it contains only gynoecium, then there is no chance of self-pollination. In artificial pollination, what happens is, it is for the purpose of hybridization. It involves the pollination of desired female parents with pollen from desired male parents. All precautions are taken to the contamination to prevent the contamination of stigma with the undesired pollen. So what happens is, in this case, if you see the brush with the help of, first of all, with the help of forceps, the anthers, they are removed, and then stigma, okay, the stigma, they are pollinated with the desired pollen grains with the help of brush, and after it is banded and it is tagged. This is called as, the first is emasculation and the second is bagging.